हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, सो टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डील विद द क्वेश्चन आंसर विच इज़ फ्रॉम दिस लेसन फ्रॉम द डायरी ऑफ एनी फ्रैंक। बट बिफोर वी डू द सेम विल जस्ट क्विकली रिवाइज ऑल द स्टोरी that we have discussed earlier. So as you know that this lesson is an excerpt from that from the diary of a young girl which was written by Anne Frank, and generally it is basically it's an autobiography that was first published in 1947. And in this diary, this little girl Anne Frank expresses her thoughts which was gifted to her on her this diary was gifted to her on her 13th birthday, and she named the diary as Kitty, which she considered as her only true friend. And she mentions about her childhood, her families, and lot other things that she told no one else. So in this lesson, Annie talks about being lonely and having no one to talk, despite being surrounded by loving family, around 30 people to whom she can call friends. And thus, she takes the decision of writing her feelings in a diary. And it is unusual for her to write in a diary because she is really in need of a true friend. And thus, she decides to name her diary Kitty. And unlike other people, she is not going to mention just facts in it. So she is not adopting a formal method of writing. So she starts with the diary, with writing this diary with her background. And to make it easier to understand for anyone who probably reads it later on. So she describes her family and early childhood when all they migrated, her early schooling. And after giving a brief account of her background, she comes to the present day where she tells us about the result day. So everyone in the class is nervous about the result and the boys are even making bets. And Anne was quite sure about herself and her friends that she had good equation with all the other teachers, but there was only exception, that was her maths professor and Mr. Kesey, right? And who was constantly annoyed with her because of her talking habits, right? And thus he started giving her punishments in the form of essays on a very weird topic such as chatterbox, right, to which she replied with full wit. And she wrote the essays that were funny and explained that this trait was a trait that she has inherited from her mother and not much could be done about it. He kept on giving her essays until she wrote a satire in the form of the poem where there was a family of a duck and a swan. The mother duck was there, a father swan was there, and three ducklings were there. And the father swan killed the three ducklings because they quacked so much. So that was the satire, right? And she has written that satire in the form of the poetry. Satire is a tone. We generally we say that he taunted me. So that is what the satire. It is a form of writing. You will find in the literature it is somewhat bit different. Of course it's the same thing, but it has some deeper meaning also. So if you wanted to know, you just kindly check it in the Google, you will find it about it. So it is the satire. Satire, okay, let's talk about satires. Generally satire means that you have something to tell to someone and you tell the same thing in a hidden manner using some some characters. It could be any animals. Our all Panchtantra stories or Aesop's fable, they were all, they're not satire, they're not taunting something, but they have the moral sense, and it's called analogy. Okay, but here the satire is there, that she wanted to tell something in a hidden way, that I have a right to speak in the class. If you are if you have problem with it, then I couldn't help with it. So that kind of satire she made in the form of the poem, and she handed it over to this professor, Mr. Keesing. Okay, and finally, after that third and the last assignment, Mr. Keesing never appointed her out for talking. So that's it. That is what the story is all about. So today we are going to, as discussed, we are going to discuss this question answer. The first question is that what makes writing in a diary a strange experience for Anne Frank? So in the very beginning, Anne Frank talked about that it was the first time that she is going to write a diary, and she felt that no one, if she has written something at late, after some time, no one would be interested in the reading of her little young girl's thought, right? And both these facts made it a strange experience for her. So it is very strange for her to write a diary, because no one would be interested in the 13 years old girl's stuff. So that was the reason, and it is for her the because it's her first time that she is writing a diary. Okay, second questions, why does Anne want to keep a diary? So there are several aspects are there, few are given here. So Anne wanted to keep a diary and write in it because she had lot going on in her head, and she had no friend with whom she could talk about with such personal stuff, and thus she decided to maintain a diary. So there are so many people, if you wanted to write in a detail, so you if it is a two, generally you have the 2 marks question answer, and you have to write it in a detailed manner, almost half of the page you have to write. So these are these few questions which comes up in my mind, so just have a comprehension check. So Anne wanted to keep a diary because she has no one, and she has lot personal stuff to talk about. But as she has no one, it's not like that she doesn't has a family or friends. She has a family, and there are 30 people to whom she can call friend and loving hearts, and even her sister is there. But she is not comfortable with them. She didn't confine with them, and that's the reason she wanted to tell this stuff to someone. And the only options for her, that is the diary, because it has the, as she says, that paper has more patience than people. So she finds confidence in writing the diary. Next question, why did Anne think she could confide more in her diary than in people? As I just said just a few seconds, that according to Anne Frank, paper has more patience than people. And she chose to confide more in her diary because she felt there was no friend who could listen to her with enough patience, right? So we all have friends, and it may happen that our all thoughts, whatever we wanna say, we can't say, share all the things to the people, right? So paper is the non-living thing, so it has more patience. It is not going to tell us that just shut up, I don't want to listen to you, I don't want to read you, right? So that is the reason she started writing a diary, and she find more she could confide more in the more in her diary than the people. Next question, why does Anne provide a brief sketch of her life? Okay, so Anne feels it would be weird to just simply jot down facts without giving her background, and in the case someone might read it in the future, so if it happens, he or she won't be able to understand regularly stated facts. So thus she decided to provide a brief sketch of her life. Okay, now let's see what's written here. So Annie feels that it is very weird thing to simply just go with the formal method and just simply just note down all her personal things as normally people used to do. So she wanted to give her facts, but with some background. So she has provided some background, and why she has provided why she feels that she should give a brief sketch of her life, because if someone read her diary, then at least the person might be familiar with the person who has written this diary. So she needed to write down her background, but in a very informal and narrative manner. Next questions: what tells you that Annie loved her grandmother? The fact that Annie spent some part of her answer is that the fact that Annie spent some part of her childhood with her grandmother is self-sufficient to imply the connections between the two. Also, she explicitly mentions in her diary that she missed her grandmother more than anyone is aware of, is evident enough that she loved her grandmother. Okay, so now what tells us that Annie loved her grandmother? So now there was a fact that Annie spent some part of her life, some part of her childhood with the grandparents. And I think all the people who lived with their grandparents, right, they all love them because they are the source of love for anyone. And in many cases, in most of the cases, it may happen that the child is more attached with the grandparents than the parents, and we all are the same, right? But here Annie also provide the connection between her relationship with the grandmother, that she also tells us that when no one knows in the house that she loves her more than, and she misses her more than anyone else in the house. So this line simply tells us that Annie loved her grandmother more than anyone else. Okay, the next question is, why was Mr. Keesing annoyed with Annie? What did he ask her to do? Okay, so Mr. Keesing, the maths teacher, right? So why he was annoyed with Annie? Because the one thing that comes in our mind, that is, he used to talk a lot in the class, during the class. And what did he ask her to do? To write it? Write an essay on a very weird topic. That is, first he has assigned her a lesson. The name of the essay was Chatterbox. Next, second essay, it was the incorrigible Chatterbox, and the third, quack quack quack, said Mistress Chatterbox. So these three essays he has assigned. Okay, so let's read the answer. What is it? Mr. Keesing, Annie's maths professor. Okay, introduction is that, was annoyed with her because she would not stop talking during his lectures, as a result of which he gave her assignments as a punishment. So the same thing is mentioned here, you can elaborate it. How did Annie justify her being a chatterbox in her essay? So Annie explained that she got this habit of speaking too much from her mother, mentioning that it was inherited. So why in the first essay, if you find that in the essay that is entitled Chatterbox, so in that she has said that to talk in the class is the student's trait, it's a student's habit, and above all, her mother is talkative. She used to talk a lot and she inherited those qualities from her mother. So that is the reason she could not help with it, and it was inherited, and that is the reason that is how she justify her being a chatterbox. Question number 8, what made Mr. Keesing allow Annie to talk in the class? So if you remember on the third essay where she has written poetry, and in that she has given a story of the Swan family and the ducklings, right? and through which she justify herself. And after that story, Mr. Kissing allowed Annie to talk in the class. So on being given the third assignment as punishment, Annie wrote a satirical piece, right? And which was quite promising. And then finally the professor allowed her to talk during the class. Okay, so the next question is, right? The next one, was Annie right when she said that the world would not be interested in the musings of a 13-year-old girl? So when Annie said this word, that no one would be interested in the musings, the everyday conversation of this everyday things of this 13-year-old girl. So at that time she was right, of course. So yes, the answer could be yes only. So the yes, Annie was right in thinking that the world would not be interested in the musings of a 13-year-old girl. You are probably 15 to 16 years old, right? So no one would be interested besides your family or close friends. Other than them, no one would be interested in your musings, right? But as she was a common girl, right? And nothing was special about her. She was a very common girl. And no one would want to know her feelings. And so no one would read her diary. So at that time when she said that no one would be interested in these musings of the small little girl, and at that time she was quite right. There are some examples of diary or journal entries in the before you've read section. We did it with the intro, where we find the introduction of this a diary from a young girl. Okay, and compare this with what Annie writes in her diary. What language was the diary originally written in? In what way is Annie's diary different? So now Annie's diary was actually written in a Dutch language, right? So actually it was written in a Dutch language, and her diary is different from that of others on various aspects. So her diary was actually written in a Dutch, and it was completely different on various other aspects. She had named her diary Kitty, so it was completely other aspects. She thought of it as her only true friend. So it is also various aspects, it's also various things, and she could confide in Kitty. Now it's totally strange, the person could confide in a little thing, non-living thing. So that is Kitty for her. So it is different thing, and she treated it as another person. It's most important. She treated it as another person. She treated it as her true friend. So it's more important. And because according to her, paper has more patience than people. Why she did that? Because she thought that paper has more patience than the people. And she started by writing, "Dearest Kitty," that we have seen, right? She quoted, she called her diary "Dearest Kitty" and ended the account by writing "Yours, Annie." So she, as in the form, she is writing a letter. So in that format, she has written everything, right? So it is completely different. Why does Annie need to give a brief sketch about her family? Does she treat Kitty as an insider or an outsider? Okay, so that's the question. The answer is written here. Annie feels it would be weird to just simply jot down the facts without giving her background. And in case someone might read it in the future, he or she won't be able to understand a vaguely stated facts. So thus, she decided to provide a brief sketch of her life. She treats Kitty as an insider, as it was her only true friend with whom she could share each and everything. Okay, so now what is written here, that it is completely weird to simply just note down all the facts about oneself in the diary, so without giving the background, right? Whatever she has to tell, okay, if she started writing without giving her background, then it is completely weird. So basically, the diary is not just the escape of her thoughts, it's her true friend, and that's the reason she has given the background of herself. And she also thinks that if someone might think in the future, he or she won't be able to understand this if she hasn't written her background. So in order to avoid, so she has given her background, and she even provided a brief sketch of her life, and she even gave the name the diary Kitty, and she treated it as an insider, as it was her true friend. So it was the insider, not the outsider, okay, and with whom she could share each and everything. If it would be outsider, then it won't be she won't be attached with her too much. So how does Annie feel about her father, her grandmother, Mrs. Kripers, and Mr. Kissing? What do these tell you about her? Okay, so according to Anne, her father, if you remember the line, he is the most adorable father. So she was very much attached with her father. So her father is the most lovable man one could ever come across. Okay, so he is the only adorable man in the world to Anne Frank. And she loved and missed her grandmother more than she showed. So she never showed her feeling in front of any other family members, but she loved her and she missed her a lot. She was good in terms with her. Okay, she was on good terms with her teachers, except the old foggy, that is Mr. Kissing. She was really very good with all the teachers, but there was one exception, that is Mr. Kissing, who taught her mathematics, and the headmaster, that is Mrs. Cuperus. So she was her class teacher of when she was in the Montessori school, right? And both were very close to each other, and when they said farewell to each other, both were in tears. So that shows that she is very much attached with Mrs. Cuperus. And Mr. Kissing often punished Anne with extra assignment, okay, as a punishment for her talkative nature, and this indicate that Anne was affectionate and loving, a very loving person. Okay, so this is the character of this little girl, Anne Frank. So how her relationship was with the other people mentioned here, the grandmother, the father, the Cuperus, the Mr. Kissing. Okay, so these are the things. Next question, what does Anne write in her first essay? So in her first essay, Anne mentions that she will try her best to keep herself calm down and to minimize talking. Look at this word, to minimize talking between lectures. But this is a trait she inherited from her mother, and it is difficult to eliminate an inherited trait. It is very difficult to completely remove this inherited trait. Also her mother talks as much as she does. if not more. She also stressed that talking was a necessary quality for a good student. Okay, so she gave these theories in her essay to Mr. Kissing, right? So it was written in her first essay that it is she will try to minimize her talking. She will try to control her talking between the lectures, but it is a trait, it is a habit, and it is impossible for her to do so because she inherited this talkative nature from her mother, and her mother talks as much as her as she likes, so or more than she likes. So even she stressed out, even she emphasized that to talk in the class or during the class is the student's trait, and it is the quality of a good student. So she can't help herself. Annie says teachers are most unpredictable creatures. Is Mr. Kissing unpredictable? How? Okay, so Annie says that the teachers are most unpredictable, and it is applicable to Mr. Kissing also, because he is also unpredictable person. He is angry with Anna for being talkative in the class and gives her extra assignments and as a punishment gives her extra homework, right? But later he finds her essays to be very witty and amusing, right? So her essays were very witty and amusing, and this brings a change in him, and he accepts her arguments. And he develops a funny bone too, right? So, and he started cracking jokes in the class. This change in Mr. Kissing's nature shows that he is unpredictable. So earlier he was completely boring or a person who never commits, who never cracks any jokes in the class. He was that kind of serious teacher. But later on, after these essays, after he came through these essays written by Anne Frank, he becomes a bit humorous, okay, and he started cracking jokes in the class. He even accept the Anne's talkative nature at the end. So definitely when it comes to Mr. Kissing's, the teachers are unpredictable, right? Okay, thank you so much. So that's it for the now. I hope you have tried yourself to write down this question answer. Please make a note of it. These all questions are important. It will help you to frame the answers in the questions. Thank you very much.